And now the official Baytown Police press releases concerning the three stories we posted early Saturday morning. On April 16th at 8:05 a.m., officers were dispatched to 301 Tri-City Beach Road in reference to a possible stabbing. Multiple callers described a black male in various states of dress entering into people's apartments, stating he had been stabbed. Upon arrival in the area, officers located the male collapsed with a significant wound in his abdomen in front of 74 Charles Avenue in Roseland Manor. During the ensuing investigation, officers learned the male suspect had been hanging around 300 South Alexander earlier in the morning, where he had damaged an air conditioning unit on one of the rooms, ripping the exterior cover off and pushing the unit inside the room. After leaving there, he broke through a back fence leading into 301 Tri-City Beach Road, where he wandered through the complex, breaking various parts. The male would then make entry into two separate apartments, claiming to be stabbed. He was run out of the first apartment by the resident who had a gun, and that resident observed him make entry into another occupied apartment where the family dog ran him out. The suspect continued throughout the complex, stripping clothes off and going for a swim before stealing a bicycle. The suspect then made his way to another portion of the complex where he forced his way through the wooden fence into the backyard of a residence on Charles Avenue. The suspect then utilized a garden trowel he had found in the backyard to cause a significant wound to his own abdomen. The suspect continued into the neighborhood, attacking and damaging a vehicle parked in front of another residence on Charles Avenue.
We need to get a picture of this black SUV over here as well. He stabbed it with a shovel.
Then punched through a window of another residence, causing a significant laceration to his right hand before collapsing. The suspect was subsequently transported to Clear Lake Regional Hospital to be treated for his injuries. Burglary charges are pending on the suspect. And in the second press release, on April 18th at 8:30 a.m., officers were dispatched to the Exxon gas station located in the 3600 block of Main Street in reference to an assault. Upon arrival, officers contacted the complainant, who advised she and her boyfriend had an argument, and during the argument, the boyfriend slapped her hand, causing her to spill coffee on herself. The boyfriend, identified as 34-year-old James Adams, walked away from the store after the incident, but was located a short distance away, walking down the road. Officers placed James under arrest for Class C assault family violence, as well as several outstanding local warrants. James was transported to the Baytown jail and booked. And in our final press release on April 18th at 8:51 a.m., officers were dispatched to a residence in the 100 block of West Main Street to check by with Baytown Fire Department in reference to an accidental grease fire, in which a 31-year-old woman and her 10-month-old nephew were both burned. Upon arrival, officers were advised that a pot of grease that was on the stove apparently caught fire. The aunt grabbed the pot in an attempt to extinguish the fire, which burned her hands and caused her to drop the pot, which in turn caused the hot grease to splash onto the child, who had apparently crawled into the kitchen. The child was airlifted to UTMB Galveston to be treated for his burns. Baytown Fire Department arson investigators are investigating the fire.
West Main, they're in reference to a baby that has been burned and will be lifelike.
And dropped it and it fell on the baby. This is a critical incident page about a severe burn to a civilian.